Alright, everybody, welcome back to The Outer Worlds Murder on Eridanos. And we're gonna go talk to the chef because apparently that is. Oh. I've been over here, yeah. There's that guy. Oh, yeah, I've talked to the chef before. But he was the one that, he was having some problems with our guy and they both got poisoned, so.
Yes? Are you here for the double rack of smoked sprat? Well, I'm sorry to disappoint you, but you'll have to wait.
Oh, don't give me that look. Let me see if I can pencil you in for later. Actually, what am I saying? I can't do that. I'm booked for the next month. You'll have to make a reservation.
Why are you talking about food? Don't you care about the crime that just occurred?
Crime or no crime, I must keep my head on my work. One does not simply become the head chef in all of Eridanos by fretting over irrelevant happenings.
I'm here to investigate Halsey and Helen's murder. I'd like to ask you a few questions.
You're the inspector? Here? Why? I mean, you may ask me whatever you want. I have nothing to hide.
Did you prepare all of Helen's meals?
Of course I did. I would never allow anyone else to touch the meals of so important a guest.
Helen's last meal is poisoned. You sure no one else was involved?
Well, yes, I'm positive. Why?
If Helen was poisoned and no one else touched her meal, you poisoned her, right? Something isn't adding up. Why don't you tell me the truth?
How? Oh, fine. There may have been times I left Helen's meal unsupervised.
Okay.
Spencer Woolrich and Bellhop Owens were underfoot in the kitchen as I was preparing Helen's meal. Either one of them could have tampered with the food when I was fetching ingredients.
Alibi's a little thin here. Why should I believe anything you're saying? Why were you being so evasive about leaving Helen's food unattended?
Well, it's a breach of professionalism, of course. Why else would I worry about it?
I knew why, but, you know, persuade 100. If you tell me the truth, I might be more inclined to believe the rest of what you say.
Well, I suppose that's as good a point as any I've heard. I may have taken some time to engage in a teensy bit of recreational drinking, and consequently, I may have been somewhat less than coherent after preparing Helen's meal.
Any idea where I might find Bellhop Owens?
Yes, but not specifically. Owens often procures exotic ingredients from the creatures at the Wilderness Exploitation Reserve. Our guests can be rather particular. Let's not talk about the incident with the Raptodon pheromone glands. It's always hard to say when Owens might be back. If I were you, I'd make a trek to the reserve myself. Otherwise, who knows how long you'll have to wait.
What was Spencer Woolrich doing around the kitchen?
Mr. Woolrich often finds the hotel's meals wanting. He seems to enjoy complaining in person. While I could appreciate someone with a discerning palate for once, I believe that Mr. Woolrich simply enjoys the attention he gets from us.
Yeah.
Though don't tell him I said as much. If you wish to speak with him, Mr. Woolrich can most likely be found in his suite on the VIP guest floor. He's usually there if he's not poking around here.
I spoke to him. Alibi's a little thin here. Why should I believe anything that you're saying?
I understand your reluctance, but... Oh, I just remembered. The kitchen security camera. It'll prove I'm telling the truth about everything. Constable Keene has access to the security footage in her office at the spaceport. If you visit her, you can figure out what truly happened with Helen's meal.
That's all I wanted to ask about. Guess we'll see if you're telling the truth.
Thank you for your understanding, Inspector. I'm sure you'll find the true culprit before long.
Okay, so that's good right there. Bellhop, what the hell is this? I read this, right? Yes. Huh. The security footage. It'll most likely be... Okay, Bellhop Owens, Constabulary. Hold on, let me break down these things. Why it went all the way back to the top, I don't know. But signed tossball stick, spacer's choice. Bertie Holcomb believes his signature tossball stick must actually bear his signature. It's scratched into the handle and smeared with old blood stains. The actual tossball stick used by Bertie Black Hole Holcomb, it's modeled to be faster than an ordinary tossball stick and to do plasma damage. I got so many freaking outfits from that. It really, really makes no sense why I still have all this other stuff. And then at random, it'll just go all the way to the first thing. Because it's done it with the weapons and now with this. And I hate it because I can accidentally scrap stuff. The man who chafed. Okay, so we haven't been over here. Or wait. Hurry up. There we go. I have no idea. That's on our way here. So let's go to this one. Which is what we're facing. Okay.
So when the Rizzo spokesman said that the...
Because I think... God damn it. I think it's only this and the giant area that we haven't explored yet. Oh, shit. Oh, God. I thought they were workers.
Your life was merely an illusion anyway.
Well, let me check. There. We haven't explored this one yet. Unless... Have we explored this? I know we went all the way up here to discover it. So we had a fast travel point, which I didn't even use. I don't think I ever went inside. Oops. Okay, so unless we can go inside this, not too big.
The way they're eyeing us.
Oh. Hey, you! We've been looking for you! And by we, I mean Slug. Been real busy sniffing around Eridanos for clues, haven't you, Inspector? See, Sluglight Underground don't like that much.
Sluglight? Would that be some form of bioluminescence? No? Nothing?
Should have kept your nose where it belonged, Inspector. Slug's sick of all your meddling in their affairs. Our affairs, I mean. We're... Draw, you damn breadworm! Draw!
We can't intimidate. God damn it. I'm an inspector, fella. Sticking my nose where it doesn't belong is my job.
Well, you ain't gonna stick that nose anywhere ever again.
Charm. You're not really Slug, are you? It's okay. You can tell me.
Wooly piss! Why we decide to do this? Hey, any chance we could reschedule? Yeah, maybe do this whole showdown business, never?
Get out of here.
You don't need to tell us twice. Come on, all. Let's get the hell out of here.
The hell is all that about? That was weird. Alright, we're gonna go to the constable last.
I don't know what to make of Sublight Underground. Or slug, I guess.
Harbor Master. Oh, hey, fellas. Can I talk to you again?
We're not gonna trouble you again. I swear. Ignore us. Ignore us.
They definitely didn't kill Halsey and Helen. Place may be bigger than I thought. You go up there.
You got an appointment?
Maybe.
Appointment?
Hello. I need to speak with Cedric.
Yeah, that's why you're here. Appointment?
Can I make an appointment? Well, no, but I like to see Cedric regardless.
No appointment? No talking to Mr. Kincannon.
Not very friendly, are you?
They don't pay me to be friendly. They pay me to keep hooligans out of Mr. Kincannon's hair.
Come on, do I really look like a hooligan?
I'd say so. That said, it's possible Mr. Kincannon might enjoy talking to someone as personable as yourself. We'll see what he says. Mr. Kincannon, got a person of interest here to see you. You've got business.
That sounds like our inspector. Please, send him up.
Oh, there we go.
I thought I heard something. I'm jumping in shadows here.
Okay, so, not supposed to do that. Alright, there's Kincannon. Oh, he's got some, weapons. I want to know what's in that room now. Really bad. Shh. He has nothing. I wish you could distract people and make them go somewhere else. Alright, hey buddy. Ooh. The Dissident Queen, Chapter 3. Halsey and Helen. Oh, we've read that.
Why, if it isn't the inspector, I was hoping you'd swing by. Here for my alibi, I assume.
Later, first I want an explanation about for that nonsense outside.
Another murder? Drunk Raptidons? Black Hole Birdie practicing his hacking in the middle of the street? Stop me if it's one of those, or I'll just keep guessing.
I had a run-in with some slug agents.
Sounds as though you've already sorted it out yourself.
How did thugs get their hands on slug gear? Why don't you humor me and explain it?
In short, Slug has not sent anyone to rough you up, Inspector. That would be acting against our own self-interest. Now ask yourself this. Why would anyone give thugs slug gear and send them after you?
Clearly, whoever's behind this wants to pit me against Slug. Somebody out there is trying to smear your good name. I have no idea.
Right again, Inspector. But I can't fathom who would benefit from tarnishing my reputation like that. Can you?
Presumably Ludovico, more than anyone, given your work relationship. Gosh, could it possibly be the administrator? How dumb do you think I am? If you have a theory, spit it out.
Oh, that's good. That's very good, Inspector. I like this. Dominant, aggressive, The man in charge. I don't want to accuse anyone without hard evidence, though it may be worth noting Ludovico has motivation in spades. So, as you've deduced, I did not send anyone from Slug after you, nor is it likely they assigned themselves that task. Still, I am sorry for the trouble, Inspector. With that settled, I assume you'll want to know where I was the night of Helen's murder.
Let's hear it.
Let's see. That night, I was... torturing Elliot Nasser for information on missing cargo. That was a messy one. Didn't break until nearly noon the next day. Can you imagine?
And where would I find Elliot Nasser to verify that?
An excellent question. I had his body dropped off the edge of the land complex.
I'm not sure
what happened to it from there, scientifically speaking. Maybe it dissolved? Ultimately, though, it doesn't matter. You'd be a fool to believe me, regardless of what I told you. People lie, and I am, incriminatingly, people.
So your alibi is that you were busy murdering someone else?
Which, as I said, you should not trust. If it helps, however, you might consider pursuing not my means, but my motive. Why in the name of the architect would I kill Halcyon Helen? She was making me a fortune.
I'm not sure yet, but if you do have a motive, I'm gonna cover it.
If you do, be sure to drop by and regale me. I'd love to hear why I might have wanted her dead. I'd offer to assist you in your work, but I have a mystery of my own to solve, I'm afraid.
Anything I should look into?
You may very well want to. This particular trouble strikes me as not unrelated to your investigation. Items are disappearing from Slug's storage and processing warehouse. The thefts began a week before Helen's unfortunate death, and there have been more instances since. Before you ask, I know the difference between cargo going missing and cargo going missing. This is the latter.
What's the connection to Halcyon's murder, or Helen's murder?
I'm not sure. I'm only confident there is one. That the theft began mere days before Helen's untimely demise is an extraordinary coincidence. I'm not a man who believes in happenstance, Inspector. I do not trust it.
I guess I can't guarantee the theft isn't related to the murder.
I certainly wouldn't take that bet. Regardless, this will be fun. You out in the field, chasing down leads. Me, scheming in my office, preparing to unspeakably mangle the perpetrator.
I'll say this once, whoever's behind this is going to jail, not to you.
You do recall, Inspector, that I'm not to be trusted? But certainly, whatever you say. You'll want to speak with Ella Tinsley, the warehouse foreman. I've cleared her as a suspect myself, but should she refuse to cooperate, shoot her. No, I'm joking. If she won't cooperate, tell me and I will shoot her. And do feel free to search my office for clues while you're here. Don't hold back on my account.
Before I get started...
Was there something else you wanted to discuss?
Why does Ludovico hate you so much anyway?
The original incident? Well, I made him an offer he should have refused.
Did you put a severed Raptodon head in his bed? What? All right. That's assuming he could refuse it.
Intimidation has its role in diplomacy. Still, his choice to work with Sublight was indeed a choice. Our combative relationship stems from paperwork, mundanely enough. Rizzo's contracted Sublight to construct the Eridanos atmospheric complex. Had Lou wanted Rizzo's to retain full control of Eridanos, he shouldn't have skimmed the revised contract I sent him. Lou's an administrator, for law's sake. I thought he would adore all the fine print I added.
So you tricked him.
Think of it this way. It was a test, and he failed. It was all perfectly legal, too, which irked Lou to no end. My power grab, as Lou called it, planted the seed of hatred. And Lou, obsessed with what should have been, has made sure to water it daily with his bitterness and anger.
Nurturing a grudge is an ugly thing. You should make peace with him. You did steal what was rightfully his. I'm sure all the sniping you do at each other helps. He's a fool for not wresting back control by now. Oh, the first one.
Alas, I can't. I am, first and foremost, the head of Slug, and it simply wouldn't be good for business. Slug's control of Eridanos is a crucial step in my long-term plans for Sublight. The board needs to see irrefutable proof we are a respectable, legitimate business.
Why do you care so much what the board thinks?
Because one day soon, Sublight will obtain a seat on it. Meanwhile, our dear administrator is still laser-focused on old Slights, which can be a nuisance. He's grown increasingly desperate to catch Slug with our hand in the proverbial cookie jar as of late, convinced we're involved in less-than-legal business opportunities.
Which, of course, you are.
I wish I could wink, but it always looks like I have something caught in my eye. Very well.
Did you have many dealings with Helen?
A few. Helen was strangely curious about the private business operations around Eridanos. She said it was role research, but how much business know-how does one actor truly need for an action picture? I also arranged to have Helen supplied with magpicks, bypass shunts, and other hacking tools. She wanted to buy in bulk.
Why did you help her?
Because she paid me to, Inspector. Besides, Helen was enjoyable company. She was confident, resourceful, determined. Not unlike you, now that I consider it.
If you didn't kill her, any idea who would want her dead?
That is the question, isn't it, Inspector? Tell me, do you really believe Helen's death was a mere crime of passion? Or one of petty career jealousy?
I'm not willing to rule anything out yet.
A smart approach, Inspector. And yet, this murder is bigger than Miss Helen's personal life. Bigger than her latest moving picture.
Intelligence. You think she had a powerful enemy?
Indeed. I suspect Helen arrived on Eridanos with grander plans than promoting Spectrum Brown. I knew I was right about you being clever, Inspector. I'm glad. Because whoever did kill Helen is not going to come forward so easily.
You know more than you're willing to tell me. You know more than you're telling me.
I might. I just might. Your point, Inspector?
I've already made it.
Yes, I suppose you have. Be very careful, Inspector. I'd very much like to see you still around for the grand finale, whenever it comes. Whatever shape it takes. One moment, if you please, Inspector. I've answered your questions. I believe it's my turn to ask you a question now. What, or who, made you decide to investigate me?
You're one of Eridanos' major players. It only makes sense.
Understandable. A man of my standing would naturally be tied up in all this, whether he wishes to be or not. Now then, did you need anything else?
I like him. Now he makes us think about, you know, it possibly being Rizzo, you know, someone from Rizzo.
What?
I would really like you to go. Can I get on top of this and maybe... Alright guys, come on. But yeah, that makes us think maybe there's somebody from Rizzo's, because I'm thinking Helen possibly wanted to stop, or she wanted to stop what was going on with the, what they were doing with the drinks. Why the hell is this locked? Because it's gross in here? I mean, that makes no sense. Eridanus dry goods and sundry. Okay,
reminds
so we're
me
gonna
of a
market.
Rose. Just a bit.
Just back outside and got a downstairs. Can I take your money? I can't. I don't.
Hello. Welcome to Eridanus dry goods and sundry. The most standard and unremarkable general store this side of Halcyon. I'm marketeer Joseph Dempsey, here to make your shopping experience as pleasant and normal as possible.
Standard and unremarkable, he said. Maybe you should invest in an advertising seminar.
Hey, folks take a lot of comfort in knowing their neighborhood general store is unchanging, eternal, like the land beneath their feet or the air in their lungs. Whoops, forgot I ain't supposed to poeticize on work time. The drab nature of our store profits is what I meant. Now, can I sell you anything?
No. Let's see. Mask of the Masked Marketeer. The Mask of the Lord Cavendish, who revealed himself to be the Masked Marketeer in the thrilling final episode of the eponymous serial. He was shortly executed by the authorities for extensive vigilantism. Without the proper vigilante licenses. Remember, our bureaucracy exists for a reason, and to surpass it for however noble a cause is to rebel against the entirety of Halcyon. Right. This way. What's this way? Oh, it just goes all the way down here.
Hey, you! I got something I need to speak with you about.
Dash Whitlock. Freddy Crew. Oh, there's Black Hole Birdie. Who this? Spacer.
Huh?
Yeah? Freddy Crew. Speak to you in a second, buddy.
Haven't seen you around before, but that ain't no problem. All are welcome at the Copper Bottom Cantina, so long as their bits are good, huh? Can I get you something?
How's a fella like you end up bartending?
Yeah, so you noticed that I'm a little off kilter, huh? Damn if it ain't been a while. I'm too old to run around anymore, but in my heyday, I used to play for the Rangers.
Ah, yes, the classic career path, toss ball player to bartender.
Hey, when you tell a story, you're supposed to start at the beginning. Unless you're in media res, which is a storytelling crutch, far as I'm concerned. Serial overuse. You get it? Wait, what was I saying?
You were talking about your younger days as a tossball player.
Oh, yeah. I played for the Rangers in my heyday. My specialty was getting nailed by serves without keeling over.
What? Getting hit with the ball was a specialty?
Yep, Ernest the Bean Padilla, they called me. At least I think that's what they called me. League leader in hit by serves 2 years in a row. Folks started competing to see how many times they could hit me in a match. Called it quits not long after that. Hey, ain't safe to take that many blows to the head.
Yeah, I see. So you moved to Eridanus after your playing days ended?
I came out to coach the Rangers during training camp. But after a while, I had trouble remembering which player was which. Slug lets me bartend instead of recommending me for early retirement, for which I'm most grateful. I'd hate lying around like a deadbeat.
Yeah, right. Sounds like you've enjoyed your careers. Don't see a lot of that in Halcyon.
Absolutely. I know things can get rough, but I've had a more decent life than I've had any right to. Thanks for reliving the old days with me. Anyhow, I think I've talked plenty now. Is there something I can get you?
No, I'm good. Anything interesting happening around here?
Nah. No, but some folks have been saying there was some kind of fight between a mechanical and some spacers last night. I didn't see it myself, and it seems far-fetched. Deputy Wine Taster ain't exactly prone to wandering, nor are most other mechanicals that I'm aware of. There's a new void Dan Byrne on my nice clean floor, but I think it's the doing of one of my customers.
See you, buddy. Let's talk to this guy and then Birdie. Dash Whitlock.
Hey there. Word around the spaceport is that you came in on the Unreliable. You a new crewmate?
Crewmate? Actually, the Unreliable is my ship.
Cut the shit. I know Hawthorne's captain of that ship, but I know you ain't him. You want to try again?
Sorry to tell you, but Hawthorne's dead. The ship was left to me.
I see. Well, this would have been easier with Hawthorne, but I hope that if you're flying his ship, it means you're a freelancer too. Wonder if you can help me.
I'm listening.
I run an outfit for the moving of less than legal goods. There's a particular piece of cargo needs delivering to a particular individual in the spaceport. Thing is, I don't know where the cargo is right now. The crewmate who handles that is in the clink for getting a little too disorderly in town. We've already attracted too much attention. Too risky to visit her myself. That's where you come in. You help us out, I'll give you an equal cut of our pay.
I'm in. What do you need me to do?
Great to hear. First, you need to go meet the crewmate who got herself jailed. Cassidy Mills is the name. She'll know where the cargo is.
Sounds good. How does she know I'm working with you?
Oh, yeah, right. We have a secret phrase. I like boneless spratwurst. Say that and she'll know you're a friend.
All right. But I don't like boneless spratwurst.
Look, nobody does. That's why it's a good passphrase.
Couldn't you have avoided this if both of you knew where the cargo was?
Could, but there'd go our plausible deniability. Technically, I don't know about any smuggled cargo, and Cassidy hasn't moved anything herself. If the constable asks, I can't find any contraband cargo, and Cassidy doesn't know how it got here or what's in it.
Gotcha. Sounds good. I'll get going.
Be seeing ya. Remember, Cassidy's at the constabulary. She might be a little wary, so be careful.
What do you want?
You're Black Hole Birdie, right?
Shh, not so loud!
How do people not know
it's you know it was me?
I'm an inspector, and a damn good one.
Yeah, that makes sense. You must be a good one to sniff me out. I'm in no mood to sign autographs, and I hate disappointing fans. So I'm lying low. You know, incompleto.
No, I'm not sure about that. Incognito.
Oh, yeah, I guess it's kinda neato. Oh, what's the matter? Helen's gone. She's gone and nothing I do will bring her back. I've been trying to find who did this. That's what she would do. Track down the killer and bring them to justice. But I'm stumped. And not very clever. Being bright was always Helen's thing.
There are many types of intelligence, Mr. Holcomb. For example, your expertise on the field. Your hack attack is nothing short of brilliant.
That's nice, Vicar. But we're investigating a murder here.
Oh, so you're the inspector. Hope you have more luck figuring things out than me. You probably want to ask me some questions, huh? I'm sure you're asking everybody questions, so you can find Helen's killer. So, how do I help?
What were you doing the night Helen died?
I was getting blotto with the rest of the Rangers.
What?
You know, soaked.
Drunk.
Muddled. Preserved.
I think he means drunk.
The team noticed I was in a bad way when I got back to the hotel. When I told them Helen and I were Splitsville, they wanted to cheer me up. We were up the pole before evening. The hotel staff said we was bothering the other guests on account of all the crying and yelling and practice body tackling. Zeke said we should move elsewhere. Get some air.
Probably a good call. Where'd you go?
We ended up at the Wilderness Exploitation Reserve.
Okay, so another
somebody
reason
wanted
to go there.
Pet a woolly cow. There was this one cow off away from the others. Zeke figured it'd be a laugh to get her drunk. One thing led to another, and I think we might have maybe, you know, stolen her.
So the woolly cow on the VIP floor was your doing?
Oh, wow. That's real clever of you to figure out. Helen would have liked you, I'd wager. Say, is the cow okay?
She's probably fine.
That's good. I hope she doesn't have a hangover or nothing.
She does.
My memory's a little muddled after that. I guess me and the team got split up, because I know I was on my own at the pilot house for a time.
Can anyone from the pilot house back that up?
I reckon not. See, I went to the weather station. I was looking for where Helen stashed her data pad for safekeeping, right? She'd asked me to get it, mind. I wasn't stealing. I'm no thief.
And did you find it?
Sure did. Only there was a guard out there who found me. She started yelling about how I was trespassing and in serious trouble. Thing is, it was real dark out there. So dark, she couldn't tell who I was.
You're sure this guard couldn't ID you?
Real sure. It was dark as night gets. Plus, I've got small veins. Anyway,
what?
I didn't much feel like trying to explain why I was out there, or why I was drunk, and holding someone else's data pad, and also maybe crying a little, so I booked it. Ran like the Rangers were down by 3, and I just bronzed the toss ball in the Friday zone.
Did anyone else see that night? Think hard. Anyone. Anywhere else.
Yeah, I mean, no. Nope. No one else.
Brady, come on, man. Who was it?
I don't want to tell you. I'll get in trouble.
Not having a witness puts you in much bigger trouble.
Look, I talked to Oryk, okay? Oryk West. Hangs out around the spaceport. He's the one who taught me the breathing exercises I use to calm down.
Your bookie, murderous confidant, secret paramour, with whom you're having a torrid affair. Thanks, I'll follow up with Oryk.
That sounds like a good idea. So now you have the whole story. After I talked to Oryk, I went back to the hotel. Woke up the next morning with Helen's data pad in my hand and the hangover to end all hangovers. I don't know if I'll ever drink again.
Isn't that a beer you're drinking?
Oh, I mean the hard stuff. Beer doesn't count. Anyway, you ought to take Helen's datapad. Maybe you'll have better luck understanding her notes. Either she was writing in code or I'm dumber than a bag of hammers. I tried for hours to crack her notes, but it's like I said, being bright was Helen's thing.
Thanks, I'll take a look at them.
Okay. And listen, I want to help you find her killer, Inspector. I knew Helen better than anybody. And it'd be handy to have a guy like me around, in case anybody gives you trouble.
Sorry, brother. It's better if you're not involved.
I get it. I'll head back to the Grand Colonial then. Unless you need me for anything else? What do you want to know?
About Helen.
What about her?
What was your relationship with her like?
Look, you and me, we both know I'm a big, dumb tossball star, right? That's what I'm good at. Rizzo's knows it. The fans know it. Helen, she saw me as more than that. She saw someone who had more to offer than big muscles and a signature black hole stomp. Being with Helen was magic. She was magic. There ain't good enough words for something as special as what we had together.
Why'd you break up?
I wish I knew. Must have been something I did. At the picnic, Helen just kept saying she didn't want to drag me into her world. Maybe one of the higher-ups in motion pictures was giving her trouble over us? I don't know. I tried to understand, but I don't.
Did she have any enemies?
Rival actresses, maybe? I don't know too much about the motion picture industry. Except for Helen's pictures, obviously. Those I probably know by heart. Seen them about 100 times each. What do you want to know?
About Auric West.
Yeah?
What's his deal?
Auric's a businessman. He sells stuff you can't get elsewhere. You know, alternative stuff. We're talking sort of science, crockery, whole supplements.
I see. And why would someone buy whole supplements?
Maybe putting effort accelerators in your body isn't always the right call, you know? Maybe there are other options. Maybe I don't take all the accelerators Rizzo's pushes on me.
Maybe I should forget that last one and you don't get in trouble with Rizzo's.
Oh, yeah. I'd appreciate that. Yeah?
Where can I find him?
Auric hangs around the spaceport most days. Since he's not here at the bar, he's most likely over by the buy-up bunks at the shipping yard.
Why'd you have the mascot pull that little stunt over the recording in Helen's room?
I remember sending her the recording, but... law, I was halfway to preserve by then. I don't know what was on it. When I realized what I'd done, I panicked. If I'd said something dumb, folks might think I was involved in her death. I was scared of looking suspicious.
I found the recording. There's nothing incriminating on it.
You listened to it? What'd I say to Helen? Did I sound drunk?
You mainly said you loved her.
Thank the architect. I hope she heard it. I don't want the last time she heard my voice to be when I was all angry at the orchards.
What's it like being a famous tossball player?
Tossball was, is, and always will be the greatest game in the universe. And I would give it up in a heartbeat to have Helen back.
So... oh, that's Owens. That's kind of funny that we found him down here, because I remember he was part of a lot of machines. We had to meet him anyway, and I just randomly found him. Restricted. So that's pretty cool. Were we up here already?
This port seems real busy. I wonder if they're trying to compete with the Groundbreaker.
Okay, so that's where we could go down. Let's go up real quick. Oh no, I think this is just to the dude's office. Yeah. Okay, so we can go back down. Don't want to go in there yet. Just keep exploring the top area. Constabulary. Huh. Huh, that's interesting. I was thinking maybe there was going to be a back way in right here or something. Alright, now let's go ahead and see what's down here. Compass. I've never seen a compass. Whose room is this? Whoa. Sealed room. Huh. It's really cool that we were able to get in there. Buy a bunk. Slug worker identity cartridge. Hey, now we can walk into the place, at least for a little bit anyway. Rent unit waiver. Sublight salvage and shipping underground is not responsible for any damage incurred by you while you rent this unit. Slug does not guarantee the condition of this unit or any amenities therein. Slug does not guarantee that this unit is vermin free. The corpses of any vermin killed by the user intentionally or otherwise are the property of Slug. Removal of said corpses will be met with a fine of no less than 1,000 bits. By agreeing to rent this unit, you waive any right of to pursue Slug for damages. Wow. I don't think I need to go into any more of these rooms, because we have the thing.
Hey, pal, over here.
Oh, that's Auric West.
Hey there. You're looking to unwind, friend? Maybe you're on your way to the bar for a good time? Maybe you're interested in something a little better than beer or Adreno? Something with a little more kick?
Nah. Better than beer?
Bold claim, I know. But I wouldn't lie to you, friend. The name's Auric. I deal in, shall we say, holistic pharmaceuticals, natural substances and the like. You know, alternative stuff. I know, I know. Ooh, it came out of the ground. That's where worms live. I get it. I do. Why go for that homegrown shit when you could be pumping your body full of effort accelerators? Says it right on the Anticleo's box. Better than nature, right? Well, I'm gonna let you in on a little secret, pal. Those pharmaceuticals the corporations manufacture, not all of them are as good for you as the board wants you to believe.
No shit. Yeah, I've noticed as much.
Alternatives. That's the way to go, pal. Trust me. No matter what ails you, I got what you need.
I'd like to ask you a few questions. I'd like to ask you some questions about Bertie Holcomb.
Wait, you ain't a sheriff, right? You gotta tell me if you're a sheriff.
I'm a freelance inspector brought in to investigate the death of Halcyon Helen.
I'll be honest, I don't really know where that puts us.
I'm not here to bring you in any trouble, I just want to talk.
Alright, fine. Yeah, I know Bertie. So what?
Yeah, he told me to come to you. Heard you taught Bertie some breathing techniques.
Yeah, that was me. Bertie's got a temper, but he's not a bad kid, you know? He's trying to work on it.
How do you know Bertie?
He may or may not buy alternatives from me from time to time. A little diluted Mathis or Essence here, a little vitamin B negative there.
For what?
He's stressed out of his mind, the poor guy. Everyone knows his name. Can't turn around without having to sign an autograph. Then you throw in playing tossball for a living. Violence like that, it does things to a body. It does things to the head.
What do you mean, tossball? It does things to the head? We know. Was Bertie with you the night Halcyon Helen was killed?
Yeah. Damn shame about that.
Alright.
Bertie thought the world of Helen.
So it checks out.
He showed up drunk at my place wanting to talk about
the
breakup.
I know it wasn't him, though.
Helen dumped him, he said. Boy, was he in a bad way. I'd never seen him like that before. We talked for a while, and when he felt better, I sent him back to the hotel. Told him to drink more water and get some sleep.
What do you mean by does things to the head?
Come on. Bertie's a damn good hacker, but taking that many blows to the noggin would scramble anyone's upstairs business. I know it's knocked a few of his memories loose. I worry about him, that's all. He's a good kid. Got a good heart.
Yeah, he does seem to. He does seem to be a good guy. Security. Come on, guys, so nobody sees us. We're stealing. And we got this thing here. They go into their freaking armory and where did everything go? Spaceport security protocol checklist. 1. Wait for docking procedures to finish, including ship captain wiring their docking fee. 2. Greet the captain of the docked ship and request their docking fee. If repeat visitor, charge double the docking fee, will not be contacted in advance. 3. Retrieve cargo manifest, charge a flat percentile based tariff on each piece of cargo. Charge double if captain was surly. 4. If captain complains for any reason, call slug fixers. 5. Offer cargo insurance for a 5,000 bit fee. If captain declines, notify slug fixers to rearrange their cargo later. 6. Retrieve loading mechanicals to move cargo to shipping yard. 7. Open and inspect cargo. Anything not mentioned in cargo manifest, including stowaway vermin or additional cargo, imparts a $2,000 bit fine per pound of cargo, individual animal found. 8. If no additional unmentioned cargo is found, plant your own. What the shit? These people are horrible. Okay, we got another place right there. We've been over here. Oh. Okay, so that's a back way. Got a terminal. Greetings, employee. Please be sure to report any unauthorized individuals, mechanicals, or sprats that may have wandered into the shipping yard. New shipping manifest. Rat King. Ship Rat King, crew Mills, Cassidy, Whitlock, Dash, cargo 17 crates, unmarked, 2 canisters of cacao milk, 1 package unmarked and wrapped in brown paper, all contents moved to shipping yard. Package was placed in container number 2443 for safekeeping. Ship Nanner Spanker, 258, crew 8 Rizzo's employees, names withheld. Cargo 14 crates of Rizzo's confectionaries and beverages, 3 sets of security armor, 20 stun batons used, moved to slug warehouse. Note, crew was most likely lost and mistakenly landed in Slug territory. Should their captain return asking about their supplies, act as if you don't know what they're talking about. Ship sublighter, crew, corporal, I don't know, Leora McDervish, two shipping mechanicals, cargo, 6 crates of weapons, 2 crates of medicine. Note, sent her back with Spectrum enough to drown most of Fallbrook. Payment was a little light. Talk to the boss about it. Okay. Not very interesting. Hey, buddy. We're in security. Again, I don't think we need to really go in any of those because we did get the key card. What is sublight freight storage and processing? Good thing there's no morale system, because I've stolen so much stuff. Well, I guess there's technically a thing with the factions and everything, but... Okay. So the only place we have not been now is sublight storage and processing, and the constu blah 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 blah. So here, and then... Let's head to the back entrance and then we'll save it. Oh, look around for a minute, I guess.
You're a deft hand with a mag pick.
Thank you. We're now, oh shit. Okay, so I don't think we really needed to be in there. It seems like. Anyway, it was just a bunch of stuff. Can't find. Back into the right. Yeah, okay. Alright, we explored that. Let's go into here. And then we'll go ahead and stop. Because this is the last place to explore before the constabulary. Oh god, I'm holding so much stuff. Oh yeah, I picked up like a million weapons. And again, it goes all the way to the top. Ooh, 113. Okay.
Hi there!
Oops.
Sorry, this area is off limits to port vision. Oh, wait half a second. You're the inspector. Sorry about that. I'll buzz you right in.
Oh.
Hey, you think they keep any spare parts down here? Just wondering.
Who knows, but it's freaking huge. Those are the vending machines. This is the place we're in. Upstairs. Okay. So we're going to go ahead and save it here. Hope you guys are enjoying it, though. Have a great day, and I'll see you next time. Bye.